Boom.
All right, we are calling it because tent's falling.
There you go.
Look.
There you go.
Look at this.
There you go. This is the intro to the number 500 video. This is how it is. It's how it walks. It's how it talks. It's how it is here in the Hot Rod Alley. You just check out all these names and all these little spots, and we're going to put everybody in here we can put in here and just enjoy your damn life, people, because we are out here doing it. Ain't nobody doing this shit the way we do it. Ain't nobody going to tempt. You see what I'm standing in? It's just, this is Hot Rod Alley, and this is real as it gets, and this is how we do it. We just keep on trying, and if you ain't trying, you're dying, so just keep on trying with us. This is the intro. We're trying to figure out how to do it, but my God, this is how you're going to do it. Here's the intro. Coming down here. Where I look. There you go. This is how you do it, man.
Just sit on the roof.
If this ain't real Hot Rod, we come out here and give it a shot and try to start this thing. Lost the damn pump radiator hose. The only piece.
It's out there somewhere.
Anywhere. It ain't done nothing but pour down, dude. You can't step out through here.
It is bad.
Where all the water's
coming.
Look,
you see it all? It's nothing but puddles. Just puddles.
I mean, wait a minute. Just enjoy this video. This is number 500. Cole's out here. Justin's out here. Cole's down the bank looking. We're all soaking wet. Just keep doing what you're doing. Keep crashing. Keep on working. That's the point of this whole video. That's the point of what we're doing. Just to get everybody out. You ain't got to do it like this, but just get out and do something. Because if we can do it in this shit, you ought to be able to do it. Mm-hmm.
I wish I could get out and film, but I don't want to ruin the camera. But I mean, just look out there. It's tent's knocked over.
We do tempt it. We're lucky we got this tent. Thanks to James Morgan, we got this.
Yeah, I know.
But we're the only crazy people that try to fire up a hot rod in a hurricane.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we'll give it a shot. So we still going to try to start it.
I would.
Let's get the major fun. Let's get those goddamn winners.
I mean, we can start it, just see if it'll boom.
Yeah, we're running for a safety. That's all I know to do. You want to just see? We're trying to figure out this morning how to do the video and all this stuff, and I'm coming up with all kind of ideas. We ain't done that worth shit. It's just how it is.
Gotta keep it real as it gets.
We're gonna have another year of what we're doing right now. We're gonna have another 500 videos, but it's all gonna be right here doing the same thing over and over. You know, just hang with us. I hope you stick with us.
Mm. So, everything that led up to this moment, you will see at the beginning of this video. Well, you'll see after this, you'll see everything that led up to this. But soaking wet in the rain, new motor in Calamity, and here we go.
Still thrashing, still in Hot Rod Alley, still real as it gets. Don't get no real as it.
No.
What's this shit? What's this?
Look at old beep beep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what got me a second ago.
There you go, folks. Yeah, I bet that shit right on good.
What's he?
Soaking wet.
Friends making the same mistakes we swear we'll never make again. Pissing in the wind, let's go around all our friends.
Bust that window.
Sing and tell our grandchildren. About the time I called this guy, it was 4 in the morning. Teach me the word to the song I was humming. He just laughed and he said that the old gray cat is sneaking down the hall. But all he wants to know is who in the hell is paying for this call. Oh, kissing in the wind, betting on a losing friend. Wanted to know how in the world am I doing? Oh. ached and we suffered. You come sneaking down the hall like that old time feeling that we never should have.
Alright, so I'm trying to piece together a motor for Calamity Jane, and I talked to Mike White, and he said, come back here, I got a pile of small block stuff, and so he hooked me up with a 350. It's all together, all the bottom end is perfect. I mean, you can see the top, it's just sat for a long time. I'm tearing it apart. This thing's still got oil and water in it. See where the oil dripped out? When I had to pick all this up out of the truck by hand and put it all here on the porch. I'm gonna use a cherry picker, but it was just in the way. Then he gave me this one, said this was another 350, but look at that bouncer, it's a 327. I mean, look at that crank, that's a 327 crank. So I'm assuming this was a small journal 327. Looks like a 327 crank. And then you see the small bouncer? Looks like 327 to me also. And this is a complete 283. See the 11/32 rod bolts. But if you look, see that little notch in the end? See if I can tilt this over, that had fallen. That crank, it's a full circle except for a notch, which is a 302 crank. So 302 and 283 are the same. They're both 3-inch stroke. So this might be 12-to-1 or 11-to-1 motor with power pack heads on it. So that is freaking awesome. I might use this one, or I might use the 350. Mike said to use the 350, so I'll probably just build me a 350. And I got some 2-valve relief that are like 10.5-to-1 compression. Just throw a motor together to go race. So I'll make something work out of all this mess. But I can never thank Mike White enough, man. That was super awesome of you. Helped me out, hooked me up with this stuff. He said he wasn't ever gonna use it, so we're gonna bring it back to life. There we go, got it up on the jet, cherry picker, and drain the fluid. Still had cooling in it. Awesome. Finally got the bouncer off. That sucker did not want to come off. Look at that. Got a few miles on her. That just means it's a good broken block. Well, I got the cam out. Look at the lobes on this thing. They ain't nothing. There they go. See the lifters? See the dished? They did not want to come out. In order to get the pistons come out, you gotta clean all that rust out of there as best you can, so when you hit them, they'll break loose and slide out. See all that? It's all gonna come out. That's what I'm trying to do. Alright, got them cleaned. I mean, these things were coated big time in rust. So maybe the pistons are moved now. Alright, after beating on the thing with a hammer, I got the crank freed up and the pistons are freed up. Sorta. I'm gonna get the first one out right now. Beautiful. It's almost a shame to have to put new bearings. It's almost a shame to have to put new main bearings. This thing, look. Now that it's most of the pistons out, look at that. Look how free. It's crazy. Alright, now I'm tearing into the 283. Pulling my intake, heads, cam, everything so I can see the pistons. Think some rats have been living in there. Mice. There's a mouse and a mouse. That's pretty cool. It's a mouse living in a mouse. All right, fixing to pull the head off. Ain't no telling how many years these heads have been on this motor. I'm hoping these are like 11 to 1 or something. Since it's got a parapet head on it, it may be a flat top, but I don't know. Alright, we're on 283 now. This sucker is locked up, boy. I was able to get one piston out. Even the lifters are stuck in it. I was able to knock them out far enough to get the cam out. See the cam over there? Oh, right there. But we'll keep fighting with it until see what pistons I can get out as it sits now, and then maybe get the crank loose. All I'm after is the pistons and the crank anyway. The block, but so we'll see what I can do. Maybe I can get her fixed. I ain't giving up, but it's a fight, boy. All right, 2 hours later, finally got it to where I think I can get the crank up. Stuck. Well, I got the crank out and 7 of the 8 pistons. This one right here will not budge. Probably gonna have to bust it. I don't want to, but I'm probably gonna have to. Look, there's a 283 block, standard 283 crank. The one journal looks really good. They all probably are close to that. Just gotta clean them. Yeah, what a mess I made.
Test on this S10 before we take it down there. Cause we'll take it down there to Shade Side and run it, or Greer and run it, either one. We're gonna take it over here and see if it's got a little bog or see how it does these tunnel rim shit. But this other camera stuff ain't over here. Mike White with slicks on it, so.
See if it loosened the burner up.
Yeah, see if it loosened it up. We ain't even hit it or anything since you did all that on there. You just put some gas in it. No. So. We're gonna take it over here and give her a little poke. But, yeah, tires are wrinkled up. Hope police don't know to see their slicks.
No jingle.
Oh, say that, I said that. So anyway, he's driving over here, got the tunnel rim on. Sounds good though. He ain't done no little mash to see if it'll pull good or see if it does any better. We're gonna see if it'll see if it's a little saggy for it. Then 6 inches might be a little bit much for it, we'll see. It'll go out when it's off traffic everywhere on.
Right there,
you said,
thank you.
Thank you.
I'm not talking
about that. We'll see if it does, it'll be all right. So we just want to see, make sure it don't spend much money.
need more timing. Timing's too low. Just back it on up there and we'll turn the timing up a little bit.
Low flame both of them up?
Oh yeah. Foot's better. It's got a little bit more bottom end now, I think.
Yeah.
But see, if they had that single and that one carburetor, I think it'd been a lot better. I don't know that. Yeah, it does kind of squat. All right, now got that all apart except for one piston that will not come out, so I'm just leaving it. But now I am tearing into this, which was supposed to be a 350, but I believe it's a 327, not 350, because it's got a 327 crank. That's what it looks like. So we're gonna see here in a minute. All right, so Grandma Jenga's book, I don't know if any of you have read it, but it says to run a nylon timing gear on a high RPM engine because it eliminates the harmonics, like a instead of a gear drive or something like that, which has real bad harmonics, sends vibrations through the cam and through the crank. And I pulled the timing cover off this, the 350, well, it's supposed to be 350, and I was thinking it's a 327, and guess what? It has got a nylon gear on it. That's a GM. That is crazy awesome. I've never seen one. I've heard of them because of Grumpy Jenkins' book, but I've never seen one. That is way cool. Okay, so I run the numbers. 3896944. That comes back as a like a 64, 65, 283 block. And if it is, that's the only years that a 327 crank would fit in one of these. So it very well could be 307. 327 crank and 307 piston and a 57 rod with a 327 crank. So in a 283 block. So that very well could be what it is. So I'm gonna pull the crank out and look and see. I think it's a 307. Not the crappy GM one, a homemade. All right, I got the 350 back on the stand. Just soaked it down with some purple power. And I'm gonna clean it up. Clean all the oil gallons, clean everything real good and hone it. Throw my bearings in it, put the crank in it, get it all poked down. Then order rings and stuff for the pistons, and then I'm gonna clean the piston stuff up. So I was able to get that one piston out of the 283, put up a crazy fight. My God, it's the worst I've ever dealt with. But it finally came out, had to break it, but it came out. So there's another 283 crank and another set of 283 rods for a 302. So there we go. All right, I was honing a block, but the drill went dead. So now I'm just gonna clean my pistons. Clean my little wire brush. That sucks. But it got all cleaned up, looks pretty good, considering, compared to the way it did look. There's actually an engine under all that grime. All right, fixing to put the crank in. Fixing to put the crank down in it and torque it. All right, crank's in, torque down. 70 foot pounds. Check it out. See that? Smooth. Benefits of a wore out motor. Brand new bearings, everything. I got a good feeling about this one. It ain't nothing special. That's usually what I do best with, is junk that nobody else likes. Nothing special. I usually make them run faster than anything else. So, we'll see. There she is. Little tree feedy. All right, putting the rods and pistons and everything in. They're number one. All right, cam's in, crank's in, all the pistons are in. There's the bad one, but whatever. This is a roller cam. Well, got it all in there. You just gotta, I'm gonna drive, put the heads on it, bolt the heads on, and put the lifters in and check, make sure everything's, all the geometry's right. See if I need longer push rods or not, but it's in there. All right, got the oil pan on, time cover on, cam in, crank in, pistons in, rods, all that stuff. Just gotta button it up the rest of the way and paint it. Flip that thing over. All right, got the roll lifters in. And they go.
Just got it all on the thing, ready to go.
Yeah.
Got the cam in it, roller lifters in it, and just chasing threads, make sure everything's clean. Still got some shit in it.
Oh, look, it's real bad.
Hard to believe that's one of them motors that y'all seen the pictures of just last week, right?
Well, no, it's not hard to believe yet. But once it's painted, it'll be.
Same motor.
Yeah, same VIN number.
Yep.
397-0010.
Coming together. Really good.
It's
plain Jane 350.
Yeah, that's what this is.
Plain Jane.
As you can see, nothing fancy. Stock junk. This is, I tore out of that other motor.
Yeah.
When I was all locked up.
Real shit right there.
You can, it's a fact. You can prove it by looking at the piston. Back here in the corner though. The one that's all corroded.
Yep.
All that fancy
yeah,
stuff.
Go ahead and cringe, everybody. Yep, that's it. Real piston. You seen it up there behind the building getting beat out. There you go. That's the same piston. So there you go. Cylinders look all good, nice and slick, nice hole. Done good. Roller is in.
Rolling. I'm gonna bolt the head on. Not torque it, just bolt it on and check my geometry for my rockers and whatnot. Fix and put the heads on this motor and torque them down. And got to looking. There are more casualties of the extreme RPM. That's why you gotta run stud girdles. See that? One, two, killed three of them on this head. See. And on the other head, I don't know if it hurt any on this one. No, yeah, it got one, but I can already see. One, no, two. You got that one, and that one, and that one. I guess I'll just have to replace them all just to be safe.
So yeah, run stud girdles on high RPM engines. There's a reason everybody does it.
That's why. And I, Colton had a set of studs, so I put them in. There's all my bent ones. Now I got the heads on, heads are torqued. New studs are in. Now I just got to clearance my rockers. Put the rockers on, and then should be ready to drop back in there and prime it and fire it. So, that's it. All right, rotated over. Got all the valves set, all the lashes right. I got to zero it out. And put the valve covers on it and set an intake on it. It'll be ready to haul. There it is. All right, 350's painted. It's not Chevy orange, but it's orange. It's pumpkin orange, because that's all Walmart had, so that's what I bought. They didn't have no Chevy orange, they didn't have no kind of automotive crap. And didn't want to do it black, so pumpkin orange it is. Come out here today to put my motor in. It has not rained for a week. And yeah. So once again, under the tent, in the rain, trying to put a motor in.
It plays out here is like, what? They're back? You kidding?
Yeah.
Not happening.
2 weekends we ain't been out here.
Seems like every time I damn do something, they make a vacation, it comes a hurricane. Maybe one of them cruising up through here.
Oh, yeah. All right, water pump on. Let me plug it in. Brand new flywheels on, torqued. Motor mounts on, fuel pump block off on. All right, I had the intake and carbs and valve covers and everything on. Had to take it all off so we could lift it up. Got to put oil in it, prime it, put the bronze gear on the distributor, and then we'll set it in. But there it is, plain Jane.
Plain Jane.
No frills, no stars, nothing special, just plain. All right, priming it. All oil don't come out, all the rockers all at once. You gotta rotate the motor a little bit at a time, and it takes forever, but it does work. Most of our other drills would have done been burned up by now.
Well, this drill here, this is the biggest piece of crap. We made it as long as any drill, it's better than anything.
Yeah, you like it? Like that tape for the cord?
Yeah.
Don't move it too much, it'll short out.
Maybe a new cord for a drill.
So well, it works.
Drill's at least. Right?
That thing was real easy to turn until I put them valve springs on it. Them are serious valve springs. Look at that. And I had to run this oil, which is like $29.99. Well, it was $32 after tax.
Yeah, we're gonna look here and try to find some off-road oil that had zinc in it. You can't tell what's what.
Yeah. They took the zinc out of Rotella. Well, not all the zinc, but a lot of the zinc out of the Rotella like we used to run, because I guess it was killing bald eagles or something. I don't know. But and bald eagles are just dropping from the skies because we need ZDDP, zinc phosphate, whatever it's called, to coat the lobes of the cam and the bearings and everything else. Puts a nice coating on them to protect them. But like I said, it was killing bald eagles left and right, so they had to get rid of it. Yeah, and I guess this is gonna be the 500th video. I'm putting everybody's, all the burnouts, everything you'll see in this video, but yeah, 500 videos. But we was gonna go do some street dynos and some burnouts, but everything's broke, so it's got no motor.
Make it very simple and effective.
Yeah, you can watch me tear apart 3 or 4 different engines and put them together and build this, and maybe hear it run before the end of this video. Not tonight, but maybe tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
But you get to hear the roll cam. Got to put the bronze gear. I'll take a distributor with me for the bronze gear on it. But yeah, this is the 500th video. So wish we could have done something a little bit more, you know, crazy and fun and burnouts and street dynos and everything else. But like I said, everything's broke. Rear is busted in the truck, broke both axles. 57's tucked away behind the 64. 64 can't move because ain't got no motor in it.
We're going to find a little bit of oil footage. Y'all been wanting to see some oil footage.
Yeah.
A little bit of that in 500.
You want to see Dad's first burnouts in the truck?
Yeah.
When it had
street dynos.
Yeah, it had. No, the seat was out of, what was it, a Grand Am seat that you just set in there?
Yeah.
It was a Grand Am seat that he just set in there, like no bolts or nothing. We just put new doors on it. He had to hold the door with one arm. There had no back glass. It had a piece of pool siding that he had cut out and put in there to keep water out. That fell out. We didn't put that in. We had just put the fiberglass front end on, and it had that god-awful quadra jet that you cussed and hated.
But first, I took one of those stand-up tools, and I ruined that cow hood strip, and I made that cow hood strip out of that tool. Molded all in, everything put on the steel hood.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll show you the footage of when Dad first fired the truck after it set since, what was it, 96 or 99?
Yeah. Yeah.
We went over there and fired it up. This is why Colton wanted the camper on the back of his S10. A lot of people wonder why he wants a camper on the back. But it's because Dad's black truck, he strolled around with that camper on the back, and it was the coolest thing. It was just awesome. And it was the best.
We'll tell you a few stories about the truck. Let's add them in there too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Big Daddy Dale Wilson, and this is Skull Garage 2005. This is a motor I put in on my birthday, which we had all fucked up and it wouldn't run. But if you recognize this is an old friend. This is the truck, the biggest piece of hell ever be in Asheville. But it does sound pretty good, so.
Oh, yeah.
Let's fire it up, what do you say?
What was the problem?
The problem was we had the timing fucked up and it wouldn't run. Now I believe it'll start.
Yeah, we'll see.
Let's just see.
Yeah, let's see.
What'd I tell you?
It was only a matter of time.
It may not be the baddest thing around here, but it's fucking rowdy. Ah, chances have heard it. Next year, we ain't trying to outrun nobody. We ain't trying to start no shit with nobody. The reason I put this whole heap together is because I'm going to have some damn fun, because everybody else goes, everybody has fun, and fuck, I'm going. So, and Justin, he's going to take his training in this truck. We're going to go out Mike White's and learn how to 60-foot this thing and learn how to run it, and I'm going to take him down to Greer and let him just tire hell out of it.
Oh, yeah.
And if it blows, it blows. We're going to put a little roll bar in it. I got the slicks down there in the garage for it. We're still doing it cheaper than everybody else. But this old heap's running, and this thing's going to be running, and we're going to be out. I don't even think I'll paint the damn thing. Shit, it looks pretty good.
Let me check it.
See, the overtime stickers come off the windshield duct, but it's stayed on there since '99. If you look at the inspection sticker, '99 is the last time this thing is out. So, we've checked it out. I put some transmission fluid in. The transmission set over here since '99. Hell, it jumped right in gear. Perfect. Hell, can't beat that. I thought I was going to have to go buy me a cook, but I ain't got to. Hell, it all works. Got to put a radiator in it, throw a fan on it, get out here and dyno this motherfucker. Let Justin dyno it. Hell, we're all going to drive it. Shit, Dax is going to drive it. I don't know. We'll put a hitch on it and tow something. Shit, I don't know. We'll go to the dump or anything else. We'll be the baddest one to dump with anyway. We ain't trying to start no shit with nobody, but we're going to be down there running. We're going to do something with this thing. We ain't going to just do nothing but burnouts and blow it up and push it back up here. We might do that. I don't know, but it's 2005 Skull Garage. Stay with us. I got to get that phone shit of people calling in.
It's going to run and move.
Brakes locked up on it.
Nuh-uh.
It depends.
Yeah.
As soon as I put on the fucking brakes, it locked
mean, this same truck, this truck has been around my whole life pretty much.
It's an old truck, but if that thing can talk, man.
Oh, it has talked. It talked at Bristol. It went kapow.
Colton told him that thing when he was 2 years old.
Yeah.
Kid.
He climbed in it and kicked it out of park because Dad had pulled the pin out so he could shift it easy with his fingers when he's doing burnouts or racing. And he got in there and climbed around and pulled it, and it rolled off down the bank, down across the road, hit a tree and tore the front end up. And what was he saying when you went down there?
You know, I went outside and I looked for my truck and I thought, damn truck. And it was down, all I could see was the ass of the truck sticking out of the pine tree. And Colton was climbing through the damn back wind and he was going dab. What did my truck up, man? It got the hood, the bumper, grill, ready.
But yeah. But yeah, see, what people don't realize is that Dad drove this truck every day, everywhere he went, all the time, to work, to pick us up from school, in the snow. This was his daily driver. Had a 456, that 3000 stall, and them 11-to-1 pistons. He put a 76cc head on it to drop a compressor so he could pour gas for it.
I didn't have nothing else to drive. I screamed. I didn't sit in the car.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't have nothing. I'd drive it in the snow, and had the fuel cover up on the front fender, and it'd get so much ice on it, I'd have to stop and knock the ice off that fender.
Yeah. That was all before it became a fiberglass front end. That's when I had a bench seat in it, and it was just, he actually did all the interior stuff in it. It looked real good at one time.
And it was in terrible shape when I got it, and it got in more terrible shape. It was pimple.
Mm.
Ain't nobody that drove that truck or even touched it.
Yeah.
When we started on it, ain't no way. It was sad.
But we built it all.
What's crazy about it, the way the motor sounded in the truck, the way the truck looked, the way the motor sounded, it had that Gold Velocity stack on it.
Mm-hmm. Had the Moroso Gold Valve covers off Sonny Chapman's car and the Gold Velocity stack.
Yep.
And you'll see the video when he starts it up. It looks like...
We go over and work on that thing. I didn't live over in the house. We go work on it outside just like this.
Mm. We had the toolbox in the Suburban or the minivan. We had the little red Aerostar van.
Yeah.
Did it all. And then we finally trailered it out to the trailer out there. And then that's when you put the quarters on it and did all the interior stuff, put good seats and stuff in it. And took it over to Mike Watts and did your first actual set of burnouts. And then the battery died because the alternator quit working. And then Mom and Colt had to come jump us off.
Yeah.
And then you fired it up and then you was trying to just hop a wheelie.
And then the first burnout, it got sideways down in the road and it hadn't been moving. 10 years or something like that. Got down on the front brake lock that's on it. Spun me off the side of the road.
Yeah.
It would not move. Here I am out in the middle of the road. The mud snowed on it and down. Brakes
are
hung up, barely got it back up the house. It's
pissed. Yeah. You'll see. It is what it is. It's a truck.
It's too
slow. This thing has been here forever. I mean, I love this truck. If it wasn't for this truck, there'd be no Calamity, there'd be no 74, there'd be none of these hot rods. All right, motor is set down in there. We got the front mounts in. Still got to put my motor plates on it. I gotta get under it and put the cross member in and it should be in there. Then I'll probably put the distributor on, put the headers on and all that stuff. Tomorrow, you think?
We're gonna do a little bit tonight. Yeah. Mm. I think 9:30.
But yeah, she's in there. Yep. Sweet. Alright, motor is in, carburetors are on, distributor's cap is in, spark plugs are in, starters are on. Got to put alternator, radiator, drive shaft, shifter, Z-bar, all the little piddly crap. We'll do that tomorrow. Hurricane weather. See this? I mean, it's just muddy, soaking, wet mess. But we moved the big tent forward so that we could be over the car because, you know, what's the point of having a tent if it doesn't cover anything? And phone's out here. Dad's racking that down so the hurricane don't blow it away. And we're gonna put the headers on, radiator, alternator, all that little crap, and then start up running for about 10-15 minutes to let everything meet up with one another. So yeah. Yeah. you.
Hurricane 2017.
Never fails, does it?
No.
Every vacation I take, last night I took the damn hurricane.
Mm-hmm. Same, well, you're sick and hurricane.
Yeah, we just can't get out of it. It's just, you can't quit working like this. It's never fails, man. Yeah, there you go.
Better watch it, Colton.
What?
Be careful. It'll get you.
Crazy shit, man.
I like how that water splashed right into the front of the car. Right where you were. See, it got me a minute ago. Soaked me good. But, oh well, we're going to make noise today, one way or another.
Speak too soon.
What can happen? Hurricane, blow in, hell, and tornado?
Don't say that. You can watch it hit in Hot Rod Alley.
That's it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look at both of our tents.
Oh, what a mess. All right. Maybe better luck tomorrow.
Huh? It'll be like this till Thursday.
We can't do this till Thursday. Yeah. We'll all float away.
So, I just watched this video, and we're going to do a little rendition of Singing in the Rain. You want to go? Y'all ready?
I don't know the words to
sing. Singing in the rain.
Thrashing in the rain.
A beautiful day.
Oh, God. Is that them?
Yeah. Thank God I'm a country boy.
Yeah.
Don't you gonna dance on me with me?
All right.
Oh, what do you want? Don't you gonna sing with me?
It's throwing a seat.
Oh, yeah. Look, listen.
I'm not singing.
You don't want to sing.
The power. Water went right down in it.
Well, the rain shorted out our drop cord, burned it up, absolutely soaked all the way down to my drawers, my wallet's wet. I mean, just 100% soaked wet. We're giving up, leaving. I mean, there's nothing we can do. It is just pouring, monsoon, hurricane rain. And it sucks, man. So close. Look at this. About to, if I could find my radiator hose, put it at the top and put water in it and fire it up and let it run for about 10, 15 minutes. You know, just let everything made up. It's got a roller cam in it, so it don't have to be broken because it's already been run before, but. Still, just let everything made up and seat the rings and all that. That's a wrap on this onslaught of storm. So he's back towards the house, I guess. And it sucks. Are you dry?
Huh?
Are you dry?
Oh, yeah. I'm fine, Jake. What's up?
You wipe your face up?
That's the full set, bro. Anyway, thank y'all. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting us. Just a big thank you, y'all. Mm-hmm. For me, Justin, Colton, Casey, and the whole school growing for them. That's all it is.
Whole pile. Well,
Turk,
Dustin.
Turk, Dustin.
Anybody skull if they do stuff the way we do.
I mean, right here. Oh yeah. Everybody skull, dude. If you do it like we do it and get out there and bust
away,
that's the good thing about being skull growing. All you got to do is just. Fry your ass off.
Technically, we're giving up today, but there's no choice. It's we tried our best.
We didn't give up. We fought. We took a good fight, but Mother Nature's like that.
He always leaves that truck running.
Probably the worst day we've worked in.
Yeah. Oh, it is the worst. I'd rather work in the snow.
That'll be fine. Look at the big tree it fell. See it? See the big tree? There's my car, and there's a tree.
All right. So after the hurricane storm yesterday, still fairly wet, but it ain't raining right now, so come out here, had to rob this off the truck, make it fit because mine disappeared somewhere. I don't know where it went. So yeah, had to make one. So I'll go buy Dad another one for his trip. But anyway, put water in it now. Just hooked up a battery. Oh, but before I forget, I put this in the car before I ever finished it. This thing right here. I don't know where it come from. Mama will give it to me. She found it at Salvation Army. I don't know if this thing has been bad juju or what, because I've had nothing but problems since day one. So, and that's been in here since day one. So, taking it out. Don't know what it means. Don't know where it's from. But that's the only thing I can think of that could be bringing me bad mojo. Because I got my good star, which is a sheriff badge. See, I think it says junior sheriff. Yeah. That was Dad's when he was little. Then we played with it when we was little. So that's good mojo. This is the only thing I think is in here that's bad mojo. All right, here we go. Power, fuel. All right, got up to 180 degrees, run about 8 minutes. And when I shut it off, it didn't go ducka ducka ducka. So that makes me pretty happy so far. So similar to Colton's and similar to the 57, about the same. This cam's got, it don't have nowhere near the duration that the last one had in it. So this one should make more power than the, I had the 2302 way over cammed. So much duration.
Sounds like a nice solid 350.
Mm-hmm. That's all I want. I'm content with that. I need to go ahead and slide this away from 7 and slide her back to about 55.
But, yeah, them super stock days over.
Yeah. Them modified eliminators is done for.
Yeah. Get back down there to street stock.
But after we finish breaking it in, I'll put the good oil filter and stuff on it and all that crap. But I just didn't want to ruin my expensive filter that Jim gave me. Jimmy Clance, shout out Jimmy Clance, give me a racing filter. So I'll put that on after all this is done, breaking it in.
90. Yeah, there ain't nothing wrong with that. It's about, it sounds meaner than the 302. You can't, it's hard to tell because
you know the worst time is that.
No, I don't know. It's probably 14 or 15 initial, so I don't really want to go zinging on it to check it yet, so. Well, I mean, you got to check full advance. But I'll run the valves and stuff again, check all my lash. Now that it's got hot, so.
It sounds strong, man.
Somewhere in there.
What y'all think? I think it sounds good.
Yeah. Not bad for junk, crap, garbage.
Junkyard motor, up to $50.
Yeah. Yeah, the whole thing comes out.
Clean it up in.
Oh my God, there's no metal. No, seriously, there ain't none.
I know there's none. It's clean. You're shocked. Like, ain't no damn metal. Check it again. That's bullshit. This is a non-metal 350.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right, dude. Good. Good, good, good. And a minute ago, it was up to 180 degrees, and it, I had to give it a little bit of gas, and it fired right up, which the other motor would not do.
What's it? Never started.
No, it would not start at 180, but this one did. So, and with 114 in it, it did. It's only probably 10.75 to 1, and I got 114 fuel in it right now.
Cheaper gas.
I know.
You got to put both gas in there.
93, baby. Back to what makes sense. Only cost me 20 puku. I go race all day for $20.
Piece of chain that is off of the toolbox. See? But now that I got about a half inch of play or 1 inch of play, then it touches the, but I got a big spring underneath that pulls the clutch fork arm, you know, the clutch fork away, pulls the bearing and everything away from the Borgenbeck three prongs, because before it was riding up against it, so now it pulls all the way away from it. And it stops right there, and everything should work fine. See that? So cool.
I got a big old spring on it, too. A big return spring. I mean, a big return spring. A monster.
Nice.
What's the deal? Set the timing, everything's good, fires up, runs, so success.
still no pecking, no knocking, nothing.
No, sounded good. No leaky, no puffy, no ring sealed up just fine. So got her good and warm several times, so she's good to go.
Yeah, to 109. This thing started at 190 degrees.
Yep, never done that before. So mm-hmm. There you go. Awesome. Clammy Jane, November 4th.
Clammy Jane and Plain Jane.
And Plain Jane. Clammy Jane being drugged with Plain Jane. Yep, that's it. Plain Jane 350. $50 motor does sound pretty good.
Yeah, $50 garbage.
$50 motor.
Well, I didn't buy the heads.
And well, a few bar parts, but the basic bottom end's $50.
Yeah. Them's bearings that I bought a long time ago.
Yeah.
They sent me the wrong thing, and I put them in a box and stowed them.
Rings is $19. Engine maybell kit was $39. Yeah.
So it probably was shipped with everything. Probably $67.
It'll cost $60 or $70. Well, maybe $67. My 50's off, so still under budget. And a lot of work, and a lot of cleaning, and a lot of soap, and a lot of rubbing.
This one wasn't as bad as the 302. Y'all seen the video of the 302 when I had to clean it. It was.
Yeah, 302 was a lot worse.
Really rusted. And then I cleaned that 283 that ended up couldn't even use because it was a standard instead of a 60 over. What was that? Lots of work.
Right, there we go. Dude, check this shit out, man. We've looked all over blue hell in Georgia for this damn radiator hose. And just move the front end. I told Justin we make one, we'll find it. There it is, laying right on the front end. I said, sure as you make one, you'll find it. There it is.
What happened was, when we took it off, I set it right there in the front because the front end was tilted. And then we closed the back and it got stuck on one of the brackets.
Yep.
And when we just moved it, it fell out.
Yep. We just moved that and I said, I'll be damned. There it is. So
we cut the one off the truck for nothing.
Yeah, we just chopped one up, but piss on it. Now we got two, so there's a spare.
Mm-hmm. All right, we adjust the clutch. Everything's back together. All that good stuff.
And it works.
And I put the good filter on.
He's changed a lot about that clutch lineup and all the shit on his mechanism and the whole deal.
So. Yeah, see that spring there? Look at that.
That is a spring, people.
Spring and a half.
You ever hear about putting a barn door spring? I mean, a swinging door spring or
screen door.
Screen door spring. That's what that is.
Yep, that's exactly what it is.
True as it gets, baby. Even down to the damn spring, really.
Mm-hmm. And then I set the gap on the clutch itself at 62 with it cold, and when it gets hot, it's about 58-60. So with a ceramic clutch disc, you got to set it because when it gets hot, it's gonna. The ceramic expands, so you got to set it based on how much it's going to expand out. So, and then I got about 1.5-2 inches of free play in the clutch, which I never had before. So I'm just double checking, making sure everything's right.
Just change it around; it'd be better. Mm-hmm. Works much better now. Straighten the rod up a lot. No bind whatsoever. So.
Yeah, everything good.
Yeah, it does. That's good though. Fired right up and tried to fire it.
Yeah, first crank. Right back.
Never done like that.
Yeah, I'm fixing to start it up and pull it out. And then we're going to pull a 57 out. And then we're going to put the truck back in the hole until we get some axles and stuff to fix it. And then we're going to pull a ramp truck up to the front and put it under the tent. And it's going to be ramp truck thrash till race day. Got to be. We got to have a ramp truck. It needs to be fixed.
If I can get the damn thing fixed, it's been useless up to now.
See, it's just hard to work on it because it's all the way back here, and we're like, man, it's back there.
It's just huge.
It's just too far to walk. It's just, man.
And we can't work on it because we keep doing the same stuff we do over and over and over and over.
Yeah, because we keep tearing up the same stuff over and over and over.
It's all good.
But this one, I ain't going to turn this motor through the moon. It's not going to see, 7,500, 8,000 RPM with stock stuff. 6 is where I'm putting the limiter at, and I'm gonna leave it about 4 and shift it 58, 6, somewhere in there, at least for a while. Just want to make some passes. I just want to make passes with it. So I'll baby it, and I'll baby it, and everything will be all right, and hope for the best. So, I mean, I'm gonna baby it to a certain extent. I'll baby it to a certain extent. I'm not gonna go up there and granny race it, but.
Been back here.
So we're going.
Big cat branch was she saying?
Yeah, we're gonna stick the front end on. I'm gonna move it out of here, out of the hole, and yeah. Oh, she lives again. Efficient.
Safety clutch.
Yeah, I guess I could. I might back it up here with a little pavement pad and turn it like three and dump the clutch.
Fires right back up. Well, that's good. That was cool right there, wasn't it? That grabs and releases just fine. It just spins.
Oh, I mean, it just felt like it was just...
It didn't even try to hook. It wasn't even trying to hook. It just spun.
My muscle on my leg hurts.
You ain't done that in a while, have you? Yeah, it seemed like it don't smell anything. It's fine.
No, I mean, that's what I'm saying. It felt like it... come up, but it just felt like the car sat there.
It did. It just sat there. It just boom.
Here it's 165 degrees, first crank.
Yeah. What'd you turn pressure. To that last time? Not much.
32,
35. Well, it damn, it sounds.
I just went boom, boom.
That old motor's strong.
Yeah, it's got grunts.
It does. That's what I mean. It's strong. It's just it like sounds. Rum. It sounds strong.
Cool. That's pretty fired right up, man. Oil pressure is about 60 the whole time.
Yeah.
Idle's 1400. You
didn't see when you pull out. It's still bum-ba-da-bum-ba-da-bum. It's right where it's easier to drive.
It come up when I launched it. It come down and then I just push the clutch in and let it stop. It goes back to 14. So.
Hell yeah.
Yes. I'm tickled about that. That's key.
I get the battery out so you can put it in the clutch.
He has no brakes at all.
Okay, so we did the shuffle. The ramp truck is on the tents. We can work on it. 74 is back here because they ain't gonna be driving it. And black truck is back here until we get the axles. And 57 is on the trailer, ready to go to Shadyside.
Yeah,
sure. October 11th, day before Dad's birthday, 57 is on the trailer ready for the race. Oh my God. Now, we just put it on there. We're not going to say it's ready for the race. We don't want to jinx nothing, but. Yeah, then we're going to stick 64 right there, and there they shall wait.